Recently, there are many China brands that have launched 60 kilowatt, 80 kilowatt fiber laser cutting machine. Most of them stay in 10 kilowatt, maximum 20 kilowatt.
I believe that will surprise you a lot.
We arrive in the biggest stainless steel market in Foshan. Recently, there are many China brands that have launched 60 kilowatt, 80 kilowatt fiber laser cutting machine. Well, when we look at Trumpf or Bystronic or Amada, these international brands, they are not so aggressive in power improvement. Most of them stay in 10 kilowatt, maximum 20 kilowatt. So what's the performance difference between these two machines? I mean, high power Chinese brands and medium or low power of these world famous brands. I want to check from the customer side view. I mean, how is the performance difference between these power engine brands difference? So we come up with this episode of the topic. I want to bring you to the top market in China, in South, in Foshan, which is one of, not one of the, but the really the number one, the biggest stainless steel processing market. Has been established, I mean, in my career life, my first laser cutting machine was sold in this market. So they have almost all the brands of laser cutting machines in one market. So we can, I want to go there and visit all these job shop owners. They have, many of them have both Trumpf and Chinese brands machines, high power and Trumpf. So we can go face to face talk with them. What's the difference in performance of these two kinds of machine? Super high power from China and medium, like 10 kilowatt, the basic power from Trumpf and Amada. How is the portfolio, the ROI, the investment to return of these two kinds of machines? I think this is also very interesting for you. Follow me. In the biggest stainless steel market in Foshan, in south of China, Liyuan Metal Market. This market is one of is the toppest stainless steel processing market. In this market, you can find any kinds of stainless steel material, and you can make the material to the part. In this market, approximately 500 installations of fiber laser cutting machines, including all brands, all the brands you can see in the market, and all power range. I remember in 2007, the second laser machine from Penta is installed in this market. So in my career life, I visit this market many, many times. And you can see the advertisement here. They have one shop, they have five 40 kilowatt laser cutting machines, and many they have 6 kilowatt pipe machines with bevel cutting and all kinds, that all the top level machines, the biggest power of Trumpf, the biggest power of Chinese brands.
So after the trip from the biggest stainless steel processing market from Foshan in south of China, we got the conclusions of 3 points. Trumpf is losing the market in China because it's very expensive. And the laser cutting price here in China is so cheap. Then if you buy a Trumpf machine, the profits of the laser cutting job shops, the ROI will be very bad, and the investment return time will be very long. So that's why most of the people are choosing Chinese brands of laser cut machine. And this is the fact. Second, the most popular power, in the market is 20 kilowatt and 30 kilowatt. Because when, in terms of price and cutting speed, 20 kilowatt and 30 kilowatt is the most cost-effective version. Because they cut like thickness from 4 to 20 or 30. My steel or stainless steel goes in very fast speed. And power less than 6 kilowatt is mainly cutting sheets that are less than 3 millimeter, like 1 or 2 millimeter, very thin material. And they don't, you know, they don't get the cutting price like per meters. They operate the machine by the cost of per hour, or even they do laser cutting for free and they just sell the material or something like that. So the power of laser cutting machine here in China, in the biggest market, is in this situation. Third, the laser cutting job shop price in China is really, really very low. And I was very surprised because I've been out of the market for like two or 3 years. And this time, I during my visit, and they told me that the cutting price for 12 millimeter stainless steel is just $0.6 per meter, the cutting price, $0.6 per meter. So I think this is because I also visit some job shops out of China and I know the cutting price there. I think it's a huge gap between these two markets. And even I got an inquiry about laser cutting service yesterday, and I'm quoting back. I think the, you know, it's the time that if you have a lot of cutting jobs, you can consider outsourcing here from China. And if you are interested, you can send me a message or email to me that I can give you the laser cutting price list in China from those big job shops. I believe that will surprise you a lot.